This video is on subtracting and adding three integers together. So it really gets into the use of parentheses, it gets into the use of order of operations between adding and subtracting, and making sure that you're showing the work along the way. Now, when you have three numbers, and it's just all adding and subtracting, the order that you do it in is you add or subtract in order from left to right, according to PEMDAS. So if I look at number one, the first thing that I have to do is I have to do 7 minus 10. All I'm doing is taking the first two numbers and doing that subtraction. So 7 minus 10 is negative 3. Then I like to go ahead and rewrite the rest of my problem underneath. I believe in elementary school you refer to it as sort of a nacho chip where you showed all your steps. Make sure you're showing all of your steps. Negative 3 minus negative 8. Now we get to the part where if I have two negative signs and they're right next to each other, I can do the additive inverse principle and change them into one big plus sign. The additive inverse principle states that if you have a subtraction problem, you can change it to an addition problem by doing keep, change, change. That's what I did. I kept the negative 3, I changed subtraction to adding, I changed the sign of the second number. So now I have an adding problem where I would sing the song. Different signs subtract, keep the sign of the higher number, then you'll be exact. So I'm going to keep it as 5. Let's look at the second one. I have negative 14 minus 20. That would be negative 34. They're same sign, a negative 14 and a negative 20. So I get a negative 34 plus 4. Again, I rewrite my question as I work. Now, they're different signs. So I'm going to subtract and I'm going to keep the sign of the higher absolute value. Number 3 is a little bit trickier. Because with number 3, inside the parentheses is a problem. So now with order of operations, I have to solve what is inside this parenthesis first. That's according to order of operations. So negative 1 plus 3 is 2, and I have negative 4 minus 2. So negative 4 minus 2 is a negative 6. It's same sign, so I add and keep the sign. Seeing this negative 4 and negative 2 is difficult for you, you could change any of these into the additive inverse by doing keep, change the sign, change the second number, and now you have an adding problem. A lot of you guys were really good with doing the adding integer rules by using our song. If that helps you see it, just write that step out. Okay, let's try 3 more. Now, remember, you can pause this video, write down these questions and solve them, and then fast forward to see if your answers are correct. To solve this one, I first look at the first part of the problem. Negative 18 plus 15 is a negative 3. I subtract 2 and I get negative 5. The second part, second question, I'm going to do the first part. 7 minus a negative 3. Remember the additive inverse, or if the two negative signs are right next to each other and there's nothing else in the parentheses, and their parentheses is not absolute value signs, I could change it. I feel that people get these problems wrong because they're not showing their work. They're not rewriting it and showing that step. Make sure that if you're missing these math problems, that you're showing your work. Then go back and try to identify it. Are you just forgetting a negative sign when you do your work? Are you forgetting the rules about adding when you have the same sign? Or are you not doing the problem in the right order? All of these things can lead to an incorrect answer. When I get to this part of the problem, negative 13 minus 4, I visualize a number line. And on my number line, I start at negative 13, and I have to walk backwards 4 spots. Now on my number line, I'm going to be at negative 17. And these are the last 3 problems we're going to do on this video. So go ahead, pause the video, solve the problem, and then press play to hear the answers. Negative 10 minus a negative 15. Since there's nothing else inside these parentheses, there's not absolute value signs that I have to solve for, I can go ahead and change that into a very large addition sign. Now I have different signs, so I'm going to subtract. I keep the sign of the higher number. I keep the sign of 15, and now 15 is positive. I know it was negative when it was a subtraction sign, but you've got to remember that when we change the equation to an addition equation, they equal the same amount. So I've got to use this as an addition equation, and I'm going to keep it as a positive 15. Negative 13 plus a negative 4. Wow, that was a quick one. A lot of times when you guys rewrite it, you do the same thing where you might forget a negative. Pay attention. Negative 17. I'm boxing out the first thing that I'm doing because some students tell me that they're really good at solving it if it's just 2 numbers. It's when the equation has 3 numbers that they're getting it wrong. I'm trying to show you that it's really the exact same thing. Negative 25 plus a positive 8. And so when I do that subtraction, I'm going to get a negative 17.